So what we've got is internet timing. So we've got the same as everybody else has got, and hopefully we'll be able to go. Well, we've got two people in the pit lane as well, Clive Ritchie and Daniele Carioli, and hopefully they'll be there in the pit lane sometime during this race. Let's hope that we'll get everything together and have somebody to speak to you from the pits as the race progresses. So, Lamborghini Blancpain Super Trofeo at Vallelonga, 4,085 kilometres, 50 minutes plus one lap. That's what it is. Oh, I didn't know that. 50 minutes plus one lap. Okay, let's put that at the top. 50 minutes plus one lap. Okay. Oh, my God. That's a 3 minute board up. Yep. Oh, lovely. So, welcome to all YouTube viewers out there at the moment. We've just been told we're online for race two of the Lamborghini Blancpain Super Trofeo World Finals here at Vallelonga. 50 minutes plus one lap. Everybody's down on the pits at the moment. And the grid formed up by the results of race one. Now, if you weren't watching race one, where were you? You should have been here. Andrea Amici has taken race one victory. And it was a real fight, I tell you this, because Adrian Zaug, Salg went out first of all. Adrian's from Switzerland with a South African mother, and so Salg is the way his name is pronounced, and he's very, very quick. Now, he was out first, and I don't know if he's out first this time because he partners Federico De Nora. Federico De Nora was out second after the pit stop in race one, and unfortunately had a little bit of a coming together while under threat from Andrew Palmer, the North American. And Andrew Palmer came off the best of that because he just managed to stop the car, select first gear and get out of the Roma curve before anybody else passed him. So managed to take second place while he was chasing De Nora down for that second place for the second half of the race, very, very close to him, finally managed to make the pass. And then De Nora turned into him at the Roma curve, came off the worst of it. De Nora finished well down the order. I'll give you the finishing results for race one. Andrea Amici in first place, and Andrew Palmer from GMG Racing, the Global Motorsport Group racing team, in second place. Then third place, brilliant finish for Manabu Arido, Max Arido from Japan. Now is welcome to everybody who's viewing us on satellite. Lamborghini Blancpain Super Trofeo at the Autodromo Piero Taruffi in Vallelonga for the world final, race two. Race one won by Andrea Amici from Andrew Palmer from North America, the Global Motorsport Group racing Lamborghini from America. Brilliant finish for him in second place. Then in third place, Manabu Arido, who did the entire race on his own. He does have an amateur driver with him, which is Johnson Yaptenaga. And Yaptenaga couldn't race in race one, so Manabu Arido did the entire race by himself and got on third place. And that was brilliant after a fight between Andrew Palmer and Federico De Nora. Came off the worst in Federico De Nora because he left a little bit of a hole for Andrew Palmer to get through, then turned on him, into him on the final corner at the Roma curve, and tipped him into the barrier. Now, Andrew Palmer came so close to the wall, managed to stop the car, select first gear and get away very, very quickly, managed to retain his position, but De Nora didn't, of course, and he'd spun sideways and he lost quite a few positions. And so Andrew Palmer, after fighting very, very hard for that second place, finally got it at the end of the day. Manabu Arido, as I said, in third place, and Alberto Viberti. Watch out for him, amateur driver, but only 19 years old, very, very quick as well. And he had a drive-through penalty, but still managed to fight his way up through the order in the number 47 Composite Motors Lamborghini to fourth place. And then Dimitri Angelbert, the Frenchman, who had to come from the back row of the grid in the number 77, finished in fifth place. De Nora, which I told you about before, partnered with Adrian Zaug from Switzerland. Zaug, the pro driver, De Nora, the amateur driver. Zaug managed to keep ahead of Andrea Amici for his first stint of the race, but as soon as Dinora took over, Amici took that back, and Dinora lost a lot of places after that, coming together with Andrew Palmer. Behind him, another Palmer, but this is a different one. This is Italian, Andrea Palma. Finishing in seventh place. He can do a lot better than this, but he said the setup of the car's just not right for him, so seventh is the best that he could do. Mirko Zanardi in eighth place, Yukinori Taniguchi in ninth, and then Jake Rattenbury. Brilliant finish for Jake Rattenbury from the back of the track. Wasn't able to get out in practice or qualifying, really. Managed to do a couple of laps so he could qualify for the race, but they had to change the gearbox on the car, and that didn't change anything. There was a little bit of a selector mechanism which they needed to get changed as well, which they did change. Finally got out, and he did a marvellous job of finding his way into the points into 10th place. Then Spiridonov in 11th place, Polichuk, Taras Polichuk in 12th, and Malagamua, which is quite a mouthful, it's Dilantha Malagamua, and Zen Lo partnership in 13th place. Kevin Conway, the North American winner, North American champion, in 14th place. Well, there is a reason for that, I'll tell you a little bit later, in their brand new team change racing. Then Sofronas and Ogara, 15th place, and Andrea Gagliardini in 16th. That was the finishing, and that's the way they're going on the grid as they go round under the safety car. Safety car will come round again and take them round four. It might actually be three laps, we don't know. At the moment, the entire race is 50 minutes plus one lap and a mandatory 84 second pit stop. Weaving from side to side, Andrea Amici in the white car at the front with the stripe down the side in the Italian colours. Behind him, Andrew Palmer in the silver and red Lamborghini from GMG Racing, his own colours. And behind that is Manibu Orido and Johnson Yatanaga. Now, I'm not too sure who's starting with that team, but it doesn't matter because Manabu Orido is the fastest, and we'll find out at the start if he's overtaken quite quickly by Viberti and Angel Burt and even Dinora, because it's Adrian Zaug who's definitely starting in the Dinora-Zaug combo on the third row of the grid in sixth place. If he's overtaken by them, then we'll know that Johnson Yatanaga, the amateur from Indonesia, is in that car at the start. But then when Manabu Orido gets in, well, watch out. I met up with Zen Lo, the Malaysian Chinese driver down in 13th place, a tiny little guy who's got so many clothes on, it's ridiculous. Very cold here. It feels around about 5 degrees. I'm sure it must be a little bit warmer than that, but it feels like 5 degrees, and the wind is up and the rain is still falling. It's been a horrible weekend rain wise because we've had storms, we've had clouds. We saw the sun I think twice today for a minute or two, but then the clouds have just rolled in again and it is still raining out there. We've got a wet track, no chance of a dry line, everybody is on wet tires. That's the way it's going to go. Flags are still waving, so they're still being led around by the pace car. You can see all the water on the camera as the cars go past. I have a tiny little monitor here of 7 inches, so sometimes if I'm not looking at the monitors and you see something going on because you've got this immense widescreen plasma covering the entire wall, well, just thank your lucky stars that you have, because mine is 7 inches wide. I'm going to have to peer down a corridor, basically, to see these cars going around. Try to give you the numbers as they come around. 210, bum, 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 bum. Top Speed Racing's Kuki Yoshikura and Akihiko Nakaya. Now, I think it's Nakaya who's driving this. It's Super GT Series pro driver. Second and seventh in Fuji, and the owner of Tenzenkai Racing Team over in Japan. Now, Akihiko knows what he's about, Nakaya does. He didn't have a very good time in race one. In fact, he retired after seven laps. So let's just hope this one's a lot better as they come round to take the start, the pace car. So they are doing three laps under the pace car. Pace car lights are still flashing, and it means when it's flashing, it's not coming in just yet. People have been asking me why these guys are going round three laps from the start of the race under the pace car. It is because conditions are so bad out there. The drivers really need to get in the groove with these conditions as the pace car ups its pace throughout the race. throughout the early part, early three laps, so that the drivers can get some idea of conditions around the circuit. It is that bad here, and that's the reason for doing it. And sometimes the pace car will come out in extreme weather during the race. I've seen that happen before now. I've even seen a 24-hour race stopped in the middle because of a tremendous storm, and that was Germany quite a few years ago when they had to shut the cameras down because of an electric storm around the circuit, so you weren't going to see anything anyway. That conditions are that bad. Now, I didn't really expect that coming over to Vallelonga in Italy, even at this time, even in November, but it is cold. I've got all the layers in my bag on at the moment, as you can see on screen. Safety car indication going round at the moment. What can I tell you? I can tell you that Adrian Zaug is probably one of the fastest drivers out there, and if he had the car all to himself, then he'd be definitely on the podium, if not winning this race. Andrea Amici, the 20-year-old, although he's got a rap sheet as long as my arm of races that he's done, even at 20, he certainly wouldn't have it his own way with Adrian Zaug, because Adrian Zaug, throughout the year, throughout the season, has shown that he can put the car on pole and do fastest laps around here. Pace car's coming around the infield section through Semaforo, which is the Semaforo, in fact, is the traffic lights, really, in English. And the lights are out on that, so he will be pulling in when he comes around from this lap. And we will be full gas down the main straight, out of the Roma curve, down the main straight, into Curvone. Out of Curvone, they will go and down into the Chimney banked right-hander, double-banked right-hander, then up to Campagnano, the new part of the circuit, down to Serrate, also new part of the circuit, and then back into the infield section at the Variante Ciccia and Semaforo Tornantino, where they're going through the S's now. And the pace car's pulled in. We're starting to see Andrea Amici put the pedal to the metal coming out of the Roma curve, and Andrea Amici leads across the line, and Andrew Johnson behind him, and it's those three with Andre Johnson and it must be Manu Orrido, because he got a great start coming across the line there. We do have timing. We had a problem here because we didn't have live timing. Green flag conditions, pace car comes in, nobody else has gone down pit lane, so we're under race conditions. Let's see what happens. First of all, we've already got a spinner out there, and it's one of the blue cards. Can't see the number at the moment. Let's just hope that that's not Andrea Palmer, because colours, Andrea Palmer's in a blue Lamborghini, and haven't seen what's happening at the moment. We've got a cameraman wiping the lens. Well, that's great for you. Now, just smudge everything. And the cameras are having a look around the circuit, trying to pull somebody out of all the murk and the spray that's been put up around here. So we do have a car out at the moment. Can't tell you who it is, but it might just be Andrea Palmer, as we've got. And that is a really good move into the tight hairpin at the bottom of the track. No, that's not the hairpin. Sorry, that's into Trentia at the top of the track. As they come into Semaforo for the first time, Andrea Amici still leads, and Andrew Johnson a little bit wide on that, so it definitely is Manu Orrido behind him, because he's pushing him really hard as well. As they come across the stripe, we'll be able to give you the look at the cars coming together through the Semaforo. So far, nobody off, and everybody managing to get through. And we're going to have a look at what's happening behind the top three, because the top three are being able to pull out. That might be Alberto Viberti in fourth place. We'll find out as they come across the stripe. Andrea Amici, first lap. Well, it's going to be slow because he started under a pace car in fourth place. Number 77, and that's Dimitri Engelbert. So the Frenchman has done very well. Engelbert's passed Viberti. So he's into fourth place at the moment. Viberti down into fourth place. He sends Engelbert in fourth. Now the timing screen changes. And it's Zaug into sixth. Zanardi seventh. Taniguchi in eighth. Jake Rattenbury, good start for him. He's up a place from 10th into 9th place. Polichuk down into 10th. Kevin Conway, well, he's got to do something here, because Kevin Conway is a North American champion. We need to see him scoring some points here. You don't need to be in the top 10 to score points. Points only go down to 10th place here. And Kevin Conway will definitely be hanging his head low if he doesn't walk away with some points from this, the world final at Vallelonga. 42 minutes left and one lap as they go around here. Now, Kevin Conway, whoa, look at that. Oribo's going to have a go at Andrew Palmer. Andrew's held him off for now with a good drive out of that. And Oribo is really on his case. The Japanese graphics on the car pulling it out. And wide again for Andrew Johnson, but maybe he's taken that wide line so he can get the power down coming out of the semaforo. And Andrea Amici certainly hasn't got away. So, well, I'll tell you this, Andrew Johnson's not having it all his own way at the moment. Andrew Palmer, sorry, not Johnson, not Johnson Yatanaga, I'm thinking about. Andrew Palmer is out. This is the Imperial car. Alto Imperial on board with Andrea Amici in first place as he comes through the long Roma curve under the bridge. And so we lose a little bit of the signal. And that battle's still going, still raging over second place. How you get out of Roma determines your speed at the end of the main straight. And so far, Andrew Palmer is holding off the massively experienced Manabu Arido. 45 years old is Manabu behind him. And a super GT racer from Japan. Oh, you know what they're like there. If you haven't seen some of those races, go and watch it. They take absolutely no prisoners at all. So, Andrew Palmer doing the best possible to hold off Arido. And so far he's doing it. He's taking some wide lines, though. He's not trying to turn in too early. Trying to take the best line to maximize his grip out of here. And remember, this man, Andrew Palmer, had his first race this year in a car at Virginia International Raceway. And once again, Arido tries out the inside, and that wide line is seeming to work for Andrew Palmer as he holds him off again at that very, very tight Tolentino hairpin. And once again, a wide line. Arido having a look up the inside, but doesn't want to put the boot in too hard because that car will snap sideways, even though it's four-wheel drive. Here they go, this is the Tolentino. I'm getting two corners mixed up here. I'm getting Tolentino and Cerate mixed up, but still Andrew Palmer doing the same at both the corners, taking a wide line to maximize his grip and more importantly, to maximize his drive out of the corner. Andrea Amici opening up just a little bit of a gap here. Palmer still hanging on tooth and nail to that second spot. And for the youngster, first year at university, I'll remind you, he's studying maths and economics. First year, and I think he's put some salve on his face because I think he might even have an acne problem. The guy is phenomenal in a race car, and surprisingly, as I said, his first ever race at Virginia International Raceway, where he took pole and a first and a fourth in both races. So that's where he's going at the moment. Manabu still in third place. Engelbert, well, he's a little bit down on that at the moment, and I would have thought the pro Frenchman would have been able to close him down. He's 3 seconds down on the leader, and 3.4 seconds down. At that gap has remained, in fact, it's closed just a little bit. Then it's Adrian Zau behind him, still in fifth place. Fiberti in sixth, Zanardi in seventh, Taniguchi in eighth, Jake Rattenbury still in his ninth place. Brilliant to do that. Gagliardini still in 10th place, and Sofronas, the American, in front of Conway. So Conway's gone down and doesn't look like he's being able to get any points here. The problem for Kevin Conway, North American champion, is it's the first time I think he's seen water. NASCAR driver and came into this series for the first time this year and did very well indeed to win the championship, but he's never raced in the wet. It hasn't rained in any of the races in America, in the North American series, because they have one in Ontario as well. And he's done it as well, just as we were thinking that that Andrew Palmer could hold him off. He's not been able to do it. Arido's been able to get past him. So just having a look at the monitors, I said you've got a much bigger monitor than I've got, and had to be so slow at some of these turns because of the conditions of the track. Some of the drivers have been telling me that the conditions actually, we get more grip than you'd think coming out of here, but look at that. He really has opened the gap, has Arido. And it's tightening up behind them because I can see Engelbert closing up and Zalg's closing up as well on Engelbert. So all these coming together, and poor old Andrew Palmer now down into third place. He's done so well. And that wide line again, maybe it's not working for him. Maybe Arido was able to get up the inside and just managed to get the power on much quicker and still retain the grip. I can tell you this, Andrew Palmer has got a good career in front of him from the way he's been driving, from the safe way he's been driving throughout this race for the young kid. 19 years old, first year, sophomore year at university, as I said, maths and economics. The guy's got a head on his shoulders as well. This is the battle between Engelbert and Zaug. No, that's not, there's his, Zaug is going up the inside now. 77, Engelbert has just lost his place. So Adrian Zaug, just as we were looking at him, manages to sneak that place away from Engelbert, so moves up to fourth place. Let's see if Adrian Zaug can do anything more about this. And look at Arido. Arido's already closed up on Andrea Amici. And we thought that Andrea Amici would be able to run away a little bit, but Arido seemed to be definitely being held up. But wow, he certainly put the power on there. Did you notice the car twitch coming out of Tolentino's? Closed right up on Andrea Amici, who hasn't been able to get away. The Italian, 20-year-old Italian, Andrea Amici, pro driver for Auto Imperiale, number 54, still in the lead, but we've got to think of how long he'll be able to retain that lead. 15 minutes into the race, pit stop window will be opening shortly. They have to make a mandatory pit stop, 84 seconds, so Manubu Arido, Max Arido, will want to get as high up as possible if he's handing over that car. Now that is not so sure. Johnson Yatanaga wasn't feeling too good for first race, and just looking at a little bit of damage on one of the cars going past me at the moment, so there's been a little bit of a coming together, and one car's come down to the pit lane. Hopefully we've got some pit lane reporters down there, Clive Ritchie and Daniele Cariotti, who'll be able to see this car coming down and tell us what's happened to it and who it is. Meanwhile, Amici still leads from Manabu. He says Manabu O here, and Manabu is not his second name, Manabu is his first name. It's Arido, Max Arido. We've got our pit cameras down there, but I'm not getting anything through on the pit camera, so all the good intentions of Clive Ritchie and Daniele Cariotti of finding out what's happening in pit lane, a couple of interviews with the drivers, well, we don't have any of that at the moment, unfortunately. Sorry about that. And it's really unfortunate that we don't have Cedric Lima here either, champion from 2011 and 2012, who was ceremoniously. Look at this, it's a battle now over first place. And Andrea Amici is still trying to hold Arido off. Arido's going left and right, trying to fill his mirrors, taking that wide line again, seeing if he can cut in through Amici. He seemed to be getting a lot of good drive here. And Andrea Amici, I will say, seems to be slowing, because Andrew Palmer's catching him behind him. Behind Palmer is Adrian Zaug, and Zaug's closed right up as well. So watch out for this, as I see them coming out of the Roma curve. Arido's taking a tight line. Andrea Amici driving the way he should be driving, and still keeping him behind him. Andrew Palmer still in third. Adrian Zaug in fourth, number 77, Engelbert being dropped a little bit here. And I wouldn't have thought that from the Frenchman, because he did so well from the rear of the grid behind Engelbert. Viberti still there, being dropped a little bit. Then Zanardi, then Taniguchi, Gagliardini, and James Sofronas in 10th place. So I'm expecting a little bit more from Sofronas. Number 169, watch out for him. Team owner is James of GMG Racing. Had some good results at Calabogie in Ontario, Canada. First and a second there for round two. Not too bad at all. Tom O'Gara, who's his teammate, should be taking over from him. So Sofronas really does need to put the hammer down a little bit more than he's doing. Andrea Palmer, well, the fast Italian, who I thought would do well here, down in 14th place behind Cerveso and Capra. And looks like Kevin Conway, well, he's down in 20th place. Not too sure if he's still out there, because might have already been lapped, I think, it's Kevin Conway. Malaga Moura out of the race, and Shot Abkhazova both out, so the Sri Lankan and the Russian out of this race already. Number 22, I can see, still parked up, Shot Abkhazova. not in this race. So not good for Zen Lowe because he won't get a race either. And this battle still closing up at the front. And I'm having a look at Akita Orino trying to look up the inside. Amici closes the door. Amici's coming for his pit stop. That's the reason. Amici didn't close the door. He was just coming down the pit lane. That means Orino's out in front. And he's being chased hard now by Andrew Zaug. Will stay out there, the number three car. Number 47 just behind them is Alberto Viberti, the 19-year-old, the young Italian who's quick as well. So we're having the pit stop starting already. Andrea Amici, doesn't matter, he doesn't have to hand over to another driver. Doesn't have to hand over to a slower driver. He doesn't have an amateur driver in with him. So things will change when they do their pit stops. At 84 seconds that they have to do in the pits, it takes forever. They sit there and think every second feels like 10, and you sit there and you sit there and it's cold. And I spoke to a couple of the drivers, they said yes, you can work hard in the car, but even in these conditions it is cold in these cars. You don't have air conditioning, it takes too much power. So a lot of the positions will change in the timing screen because a lot of people are coming in for their pit stops and driver changes should they have them. Each driver will have, or should have, as the case may be, a transponder. And when they come across the start-finish line, it will tell you who the driver is in the car. Now, Adrian Zaug and his teammate Federico Di Nora had the wrong transponders on. They had each other's transponders on. So it said Di Nora when it was, in fact, Zaug going out. Number 54 now starting to go out again. Andrea Amici goes out. And I tell you this, Andrew Palmer's gone out with him as well. Not too much distance behind them. Number 34 has just gone out, Mirko Zanardi. Bernaldi Motorsport team have been doing pretty well all season and I want to do a lot better here, but the conditions are in fact against it. Number 33 just going through my view now is Jake Rattenbury. And Jake, well, he's had a bit of a moment because he's dropped down to 17th place, so obviously a little bit of grass tracking for the young Brit, 20 years old, and he's had absolute work. I would have expected him to go grass tracking. He's had absolutely no time on the track whatsoever. So everything that he's learning about the track, he's learning under race conditions. 29 minutes, 40 seconds left to go here. And Manabu Orido still out in the lead, followed by Adrian Zaug, but they'll be coming in for their pit stops. I think Zaug's already come in for his pit stop. So things will start to change, and we'll see Andrea Amici take over or retake the lead. But Andrew Palmer knows the conditions, and every time he's going around this track, he's learning hand over fist. So let's hope that Andrew Palmer can keep his distance, or at least do something about Manabu Orido, who was in front of him. Alberto Viberti now showing in third place. But as I say, needs a couple of laps for all these pit stops to unwind. I'm waiting for Andrea Amici to come around. 28 minutes, 48 seconds left in this race, plus one lap. The pit stops, the same for each driver, whether you're a single driver or whether you have a teammate. Of course, these are gentlemen racers here as well. You buy the car. It costs you to enter the races. All the transport, all the teams, everything that comes into you from this is paid by you. You don't have any travel costs paid for this, so it is down to the sheer enjoyment and sheer desire to race that these guys have that bring them out onto this track in this one mate series, the Lamborghini Blancpain Super Trofeo 2013. And the final race of the day still showing Manabu Orido out in front, but that won't last long. 169 just goes across the stripe. The colours of Zaug and Tomo Gara GMG Racing, a lot of the colours seem to blend into each other in these conditions. You need to have a bright car like Andrew Palmer has to shine, and his colour scheme, well, immediately visible in chrome and red as he sweeps around the corners. Having a look to see what's going on at the moment. So Zaug in front, last time across the stripe. Zoud leading this race at the moment. Viberti in second place. Sofronis in third. But I still think his pit stop's got to unwind. Manu Oribo in the pits. He's done his driver change. 2.63 just coming out. And it might actually be once again Manubu Oribo. Johnson Yaptenaga should be sharing the car with him. But Johnson hasn't been feeling well at all and might not actually race. So we'll see what lap times will be being done from Oribo. Shows him his pit out in sixth place. So lost quite a bit of time. Zaug's already out there. And I don't know if he's done a pit stop. Number three goes across the line. That's Adrian Zaug. Not too sure if he's coming for his pit stop. There is a limited pit lane window here. And if he hasn't done it, he's going to have to come in soon. Alberto Viberti is right behind him, 1.9 seconds. Then James Sofronis, so he's up there. Andrea Palma in fourth place now. So he's managed to make up some time, but still 36 seconds down on the leader. The fight at the moment at the front is between Adrian Zaug and Alberto Viberti. That's the battle that that counts at the moment, because the next one along, 23 seconds down, is James Sofronis. And James, well, got a whole mountain to climb here. Still having cars coming out of the pit lane. 2.64 top speeds racing. Yoshimori just coming out. Yoshimori down in 19th place. And showing Kevin Conway down in 20th at the moment. And it looks like Kevin Conway is out of this race as well. Only done five laps. And everybody else, well, I'm not getting the lap count here at the moment, unfortunately. But Kevin Conway, Malagamua and Abkhazova out of this race at the moment. Mori, last person on the track. Let's go through. Zaug, Viberti, Sofronis, Palmer, Nakaya. And Manabu, Engelbert, Palmer down in eighth place currently as it stands. But I still think Zaug and maybe even Viberti have got to come in and do their pit stops. Possible that they've already done so or are sitting there in the pit lane. But with the rain coming down on the windows at the moment, can't see too much. You can't make out too much of what's happening with the cars. As I said, we did have two pit lane reporters, Clive Ritchie and Daniele Cariotti, who would have been able to give you the information of what's happening in the pits. Unfortunately, throughout the day, due to conditions, I would think, that we've been unable to contact them, so I can't give you that. I'd love to give you the information from the pits. Can't give that to you at the moment. 169 just going out. So Tom Agara, I think, has taken over. The North American amateur champion just taken over from James Sofronis. He's just going out on the track. So that third place has been lost. Mainly because James Sofronis just didn't have that 84 seconds to wait in the pit lane at the time. So we've got Adrian Zaug. I think he's pitted. I see a car there with colours that looks like Adrian, so I think he's pitted at the moment. Viberti might have pitted. So I maybe at the end of this, number 2.63, Manubu Oribo will have inherited the lead. I still think that he'll be chased by Engelbert now and Palmer. Yeah, number three is just going out now. So Zaug has done what he needed to do and has handed over the car to Federico Di Nora. Now Di Nora is around about 4 or 5 seconds slower than Adrian Zaug. Zaug, the South African who lives in Switzerland, done the best he can do. 2.10's just gone out as Top Speed Racing's Akihiko Nakaya. Now, Kuki Yoshikura, his teammate, didn't race in race one. Don't know if he's racing in race two. I think the change in diet coming over here has hurt a couple of the Asian drivers, and they were looking decidedly grey in hospitality. Cross the line, 2.12. Top Speed Racing's Yukinori Taniguchi, the video game developer, Yuke Video Games. He's from Osaka, the Lamborghini Osaka, being represented very well here as well. Taniguchi in ninth place, so he's in a point scoring position. Andrea Amici in seventh. So I think we've got everybody now back out on track that we're going to get out. Alberto Viberti, the young 19-year-old Italian, in front of It still says Zaug, but that's got to be Denora, and that will probably change as he crosses the line for his outlap. And then Manabu Orido, I think it's still him. I don't think his teammate has been able to get into the car as well. Johnson Yaptenaga, 2 sick to make race one. I spoke to him in hospitality. He said maybe he'll go out. We're not too sure. But if Manabu is on the case, and he certainly showed that in the first part of this race, might as well just leave him out there. Angel Burt in fourth place. Andrew Palmer showing in fifth place at the moment. Got a way to go and 10 seconds down off the lead. But he's only 2 seconds down off Angel Burt and Manabu. And remember, Viberti. It says Denora has just gone through. So Denora is still in that second place. But I think that's going to change, because I've just had a bunch of cars go through. Angel Burt, Palmer, Zanardi all going through at almost the same time. Now Manabu, Angel Burt, Palmer going through at the same time. And another car, I think, was being lapped. So a lot happening out on the track. And they've still got 20 minutes to go here. But Viberti still leading this race. Still showing us leading this race. And we've always known that he's quick. We'll have to have a look out for the number 47. 47, Green Hybrid Cup champion was Alberto Viberti. Fourth and second in Nürburgring. And third in the amateur class, because he is an amateur driver. And we do have a connection down to the pit lane at the moment. Don't know what's happening down there. If anything is happening, I'm sure that Clive Ritchie or Daniele Cariotti will contact me and tell me what's happening, whether they've got hold of some of the team managers. But it's Alberto Viberti, the man out in front of the moment, number 47. And that's Composite Motorsport, the black and chrome, one of the two black and chrome cars they've got out there. Only 19 years old is Alberto. Look for that, the number 47. I am starting to hear a little bit from pit lane. Maybe they've been able to sort out the transmission from pit lane. So if Clive Ritchie and Daniele Cariotti can hear me anytime, you lads have got anything to say. So a little bit of an interview there from Daniele Cariotti with Adrian Zaug. Adrian, the best he could do, fastest lap at the time. But let's see what happens. It's had to hand over to Federico Denora. And Federico is actually he's the boss of an electrochemical company. Where does the money come for racing? You want to race? Well, you sometimes have to shake hands with people who are not that slow at all, because fourth in the amateur championship this year was Federico Denora, and he didn't have so good a time of it in race one. Alberto Viberti still leads this race. Manabu Orido stayed in the car. Number 263 is in second place with the yellow car with the there it is. I don't think that's Manabu, actually, the one that we're looking at on screen at the moment. Could be wrong. There are a couple of yellow cars out there, and it does look like a lot of Japanese signs all over it. But Alberto Viberti, the Italian, young 19-year-old, leading the race from Manabu Orido. Angel Burt up into third place. Andrew Palmer in fourth place, and still in touch with the Frenchman in front of him by the fact of 0.8 of a second is Andrew Palmer, just behind Angel Burt. So keeping Angel Burt, the well-experienced Frenchman, number 77, in 28 years old. Second last year was Dimitri Angel Burt. And Aviatrix team, and a lot more experience, of course, than Andrew Palmer. But Palmer keeping it honest, most definitely. Denora now, number three machine, down to fifth place. We knew his times were going to be slipping, doing 153s out there, whereas Viberti, 147. Manabu Orido, 148. bit quicker was Engelbert on that last lap. 147 is Andrew Palmer. So Palmer, it's got the pedal to the metal. 147.9, it's just 1/10 of a second, but it all counts when you need to close down that experienced Frenchman in front of you for a podium place. Could he get another podium place? Second in race one, he will want another podium in race two. Not many drivers who come in their first year step into a car and definitely come to a track like this. Number 33 has just gone past my screen, and 33 is Jake Rattenbury, and he's moved up again. Now, his problem that he had must have run off track, didn't see it on the camera, but he must have run off track, and he's really pushed hard and learning, as I said, every lap around here. Didn't get any practice time whatsoever and had to learn the track basically in racing. He is now up to 11th place and within a chance of taking Andrea Palmer's 10th place away from him. Does have quite a little bit to go. There's 10 seconds behind Andrea Palmer, but we've seen late in the race a lot of things can happen. Viberti from Malibu, Orido, and that's the number three of Dinora going through it. All that time that Adrian Zaug made up for him has been lost because he's lapping quite a few seconds slower, about 4 seconds slower than Adrian Zaug was doing. Number 47 has just pulled in for a stop and go. 47. So what has happened to Alberto Viberti? Must have had come out of the pit lane too early was Viberti. He's had a stop and go, so he is out of the lead, is Viberti. That stop and go and the drive through the pit lane has lost him all those 7 seconds that he had. So it's Manabu Orido out in front at the moment. Engelbert in second place, Palmer in third, and Viberti's been dropped to fourth place. And in fact, he's 10 seconds down on those leading three who are all together. Manabu Orido out in front by just 0.3 of a second over Engelbert. Engelbert pushing very, very hard and just a fraction quicker on that last lap by 0.03 of a second. Andrea Palmer is in fact quicker than both of them on that last lap, 147.8, and the others in front of him doing 148. So Palmer really pushing hard. Look out for Palmer, the red, and just got one car off, and I thought that was Andrew Palmer at the moment at the Semaforo, but it wasn't. But Palmer's coming through right behind him. Might get held up by that car that just ran off into the Tolentino hairpin. And a lot of coming together down there. You'll be able to see better than me on your big plasma plastered to the wall than I would on my 7-inch that I've got here at the moment. So forgive me if I miss something that's happening on the track which you've seen, because I'm looking definitely at the timing screens to see what Manabu, what Orido, Engelbert and Palmer can do together. Palmer just lost a little bit of time, and I think that was because of the 263 goes through. Palmer, then number 77. He's in front of Engelbert across the line. Palmer's got into second place. Engelbert has been dropped to third, and I thought Palmer was held up a little bit, but I think both of them were held up by that driver who came off of the Semaforo before the big, the tight Tolentino hairpin. And although on my timing screen it still shows Engelbert in front, it should refresh and show Palmer in second place, because I think Palmer was definitely in front of him as he crossed the line there. Now Palmer, I think, has got into second place. Very, very quick was Palmer. Yeah, there it is, it's finally changed. Orido, Palmer, Engelbert, Viberti, now 15 seconds down. Engelbert 2 seconds down, so he's lost around about 0.6 of a second on Andrew Palmer. And if Palmer can keep going on screen at the moment, the chrome and red car. That's Palmer. If there's...
Since the first race. What did you change since the first race?
Got Clive Ritchie down in the pit lane.
Since the first race to make it better.
No, we are all the same. We are the now race 2 is position is start is number 3, third position. But in race 1, position is 6. In the race 1, is position started is 6. But this race 2, the position is start is the number three.
So I think talking with one of the guys from, it might have been Johnson Yaptenaga, I'm not too sure who Clive Ritchie was speaking to at the moment, trying to find out from some of the drivers what's happening down there. So you can see it's Yaptenaga, Manabu, Arido out in front. I still think that's Arido though in the car. I don't think Yaptenaga. Number 54 spun out. Oh, that's terrible for Andrea Amici. Number 54 is in seventh place, and it's so unusual as the tractor comes along, even four-wheel driving in that depth of gravel with the ride height of these cars, you're just going to dig yourself deep. So Andrea Amici, a race one victory, but no victory at all in race two. He is out of it, but he really did have to push very hard. He was in seventh place, and no chance of a podium from way down there, 17 seconds off the lead, and maybe pushing a little bit too hard. He's out of the race. First race winner now in the gravel. Manabu Arido still leads this race by 1.2 seconds from Andrew Palmer, then Engelbert. And have a look at them as they come round. And they're all close together. They are all within each other's wheels tracks. Arido, Palmer, Engelbert as one going into the Tornantino hairpin, which I can see from here while you're watching the rest going around. Number 27, that is Andrea Palmer, not Andrew Palmer, the American. It's Andrea Palmer. They're just coming through the yeses now, the leaders. Arido, Palmer, Engelbert, as close as you like. Engelbert just a little bit back from the, so Palmer is really starting to push Arido for that lead. I think he's starting to find out where he can get some speed, and he's driving like a true professional around here, number 114. Got to watch out for him in future, because he certainly put his mark on the Lamborghini Blancpain Super Trofeo Series here. I think they should give him a watch just for what he's been doing around here. Number three goes through my picture and just lost the timing. Hopefully that will come back to me. Timing screen's just gone off. And of course, I'll be sitting here pressing buttons and hopefully talking while the timing screen comes back up. But last we saw, it was Arido out in front. I'll just keep my eyes on there, and those are the pictures that we're seeing at the moment. Arido, the yellow car, out in front, number, let's get it right, 263 out in front. Then number 114, which is Andrew Palmer, and 77, which is Engelbert behind him. Engelbert closing up. Arido's just opened up a little bit of a gap, and then it closes right up on a different part of the circuit as they come through the Semaforo. Traffic light curve, then down into Tornantino. And I have spoken to a couple of people who say this, you can do a real Hail Mary pass there if you just hammer the brakes going in there. And once again, oh, this is brilliant. Andrew Palmer, that was absolutely brilliant as he goes up the inside and manages to take first place away from Arido. That was a brilliant move. How he got the power down, Arido didn't. He'll come out of the Roma curve in the lead here. That was a brilliant move, and you're welcome to see it. Andrew Palmer, number 114, crosses the stripe now with 7.25 minutes to go in the lead of this final race of the Lamborghini Blancpain Super Trofeo World Final here at Vallelonga. A brilliant move. And I was thinking, well, maybe Arido's foot slipped off the accelerator there, because that was a most emphatic pass. And there's your leader, Andrew Palmer. And he was closing all the time on Manabu. And unfortunately, don't know how to refresh this page that I've got here, because I've just lost timing completely. So unfortunately, with 6 minutes to go, we can only go by what we see on the track. And I'm still pressing buttons on somebody else's computer. Right, we finally got it back again. 6.5 minutes plus one lap to go. And Manu, I think he's trying to fight back. And Engelbert's having a look at him as well. Engelbert hasn't been able to do anything about Andrew Palmer in front of him. And Andrew, he's starting to pull away from Arido. Arido's coming under attention from Engelbert behind him. The Frenchman's pushing hard. But look at that lovely line from Andrew Palmer, who sweeps through. Up to that again, this tight little hairpin. Come out of here, fire down towards the S's. It's a quick left-right flick as you go to the top of the track, and most of this track from here, you can see from the big concrete grandstands that we've got around here. Andrew Palmer, were we on board with? Not too sure, can't tell. It just shows you what's going on at the moment. There's nobody else in front of him, and there's Engelbert. And look at the gap, it's opened up now. Andrew Palmer certainly has opened up a little bit of a move now on Arido behind him. Arido so quick in the early part of the race, and maybe he's lost a little bit in the last part of the race because he is losing time now. If we get the time change, it was 0.3 of a second last time across the stripe. It'll be a bit more than that. A bit more than that now as we're looking at some of the also-rans down there. I can't really call them also-rans. They're all really fighting hard. Alberto Viberti, your previous leader, 11 seconds down on this big battle at the front. Then Zanardi, then Dinora, then Gagliardini. Andrea Palmer is up into eighth place. Taniguchi into ninth. Jake Rattenbury in a point-scoring position yet again after his moment earlier on in the race, which dropped him all the way down around about 17th, 18th place. He's in 10th place. The Brit, the young Brit, 20 years old, is... and so little time on this track is ridiculous. In a point scoring position, so more points for Jake Rattenbury. But you're looking at number 114. Unbelievable drive from Andrea Palmer and Andrew Palmer. Sorry, do apologise. Andrea Palmer, I know very well. Andrew Palmer, I don't know at all until I met him this weekend. And what a guy this guy has turned out to be. Very. The thing about them is that none of these guys that you'll meet here are prima donnas in any way, shape or form. And Andrew Palmer, first year at university and first time in a race car within a few months, is looking at yet another win, and a famous win at that, if he can keep it up for the next 4 minutes plus one extra lap. And he is still extending his lead over the battle between Arido and Engelbert behind him. Viberti, well, Viberti's out of this, 11 seconds down. I just see him go through the S's as Palmer's coming down across the stripe. It seems to be going quicker and quicker. Last lap 148.3, so he has actually slowed, but he hasn't slowed as much as Arido and Engelbert behind him. Engelbert and Arido basically the same times, 149.35. Engelbert just a little bit slower, 357, so 4,000th of a second. Blink of an eye is a lot longer than that, I can tell you. But Andrew Palmer, gap now up to 1.5 seconds and still stretching out. Behind them, Viberti in first place, Zanardi in fifth place, Dinora in sixth place, Gagliardini in seventh place. 3 seconds down on Dinora, should be able to close him down a little bit more as well, Gagliardini. A bit more experience than Dinora. Dinora's lap time a little bit slower, but actually saying that, Gagliardini is only 1/10 of a second quicker, so it's going to have to go some to close. But all the action is at the front. Andrew Palmer, well, and I thought he was slowing a little bit when Arido caught him and passed him, because Arido got some grip and some power from nowhere out of the Tornantino hairpin and started to open a little bit on Palmer. And Palmer, well, I don't know where he came from. Maybe he said, whatever. Let's just put foot down and see what we can do. And so every lap he's been learning and learning and learning and seeing other people driving around, and he's really starting to use the power on that. That was a good controlled slide out of Tornantino. Now a little bit tippy-toe through the left and right of the S's. But look at that, there's nobody behind him. So only finally to get Manabu Arido behind him by 2.7 seconds. So Palmer still stretching out that lead, 48.7. His times have been consistent all the way through the race as he crosses the stripe again. 114 goes past me. I'm sitting in the commentary box directly on the start-finish line on the brickwork in front of me. And there goes Viberti across the line. Viberti still at 11 seconds down. And 2.7 seconds behind Palmer is Arido, and Engelbert lost a little bit on him as well. So it's 0.4 of a second behind him. But they're still together, as may be, and this is the battle for second and third between number 263 Manabu Arido and Dimitri Engelbert, number 77 Alberto Viberti. As I said, out of this, Andrew Palmer is trying to stretch away on his final lap. He's got this one in the bag. The race has been won, but the time has run down. This is an extra lap, and this is his final lap as he goes up the back end of the circuit. into the Campagnolo turn and down into out of Cerrate and into Trinchia. There he is in Trinchia as he comes down once again into the stadium area for the very, very last time up to the Semaforo curve. Traffic light curves, wide line, got this one in the bag, and there is nobody behind me to fight for him as well. The young 19-year-old, first year at university, maths and economics and racing. He's doing his studying right here in Rome at Vallelunga today, up through the S's. One more corner to go as he comes out of here. And look at that battle still behind them, and Arido still in second place and still keeping Angel Burr behind him as Palmer comes through the Roma curve. And the checkered flag is waiting for him as he powers down the main start finish straight. Famous victory for number 114. Andrew Palmer, his dad David will be jumping up and down for joy with that. GMG Racing, Global Motorsport Group Racing from the USA. And not just a podium this time, but a race win, another race win for Andrew Palmer. Paul, I remind you, a first and a fourth at Virginia International Race Problems. His problems at Virginia International Raceway, his problems at California were all mechanical, not down to the driver as well. And Andrew Palmer in the red and silver GMG Racing car wins here today. Behind him, Manabu Orido and Dimitri Engelbert in second and third place. Alberto Viberti crosses the line in fourth. Mirko Zanardini in fifth place, and Federico Di Nora in sixth, Gagliardini in seventh. Andrea Palmer takes the flag in eighth place. Then we wait for ninth place, Taniguchi. Taniguchi still waiting for him because we've got a couple of lap cars going through. And Jake Rattenbury in the points again for him. Dan Cerveso, Spiridonov, Roberto Tanca. Expected more from Roberto Tanca, number 72, but didn't have a chance to talk about him in the entire race from what was going on at the front. Capra in 14th place, Polichuk in 15th, Nakaya down in 16th. And Mori will probably be Mori and Tom Ogara, the last two across the line. But number seven, that's Polichuk. And that will be the last one across the line because Tom Ogara, I think, will have been lapped and will have already slotted in behind all the rest of the cars and coming down into pit lane. So Tom Ogara, last one in the results in 18th place because we lost Amici, we lost Kevin Conway, and Kevin's had a baptism in more ways than one, hasn't raced in wet conditions before in his life, comes to here at Vallelunga in Rome expecting Rome will be lovely and fantastic, and it rained all weekend, hasn't let up one little bit. Malagamua and Abkhazia out earlier on in the race, so no race for them. But Andrew Palmer, I can wax lyrical about him, but he's done a race which is very worthy of some of the best. Sticks his hands up in the air. I'm looking at him down in pit lane at the moment. And we've got our pit lane cameras down there looking at him. Clive Ritchie and Daniele Cariotti both, I think, in the same place at the same time with their cameras as they watch the rest coming in. And I think Mirko Zanardini and Viberti. Of course, Viberti is amateur driver, so Viberti will have his podium place as well. There are different podiums for the professionals and the amateurs. So Zanardini, Viberti and Dinora will be on the podium, but also Palmer, Manubu, they got it wrong. They always put it wrong. They put Manubu and then O. And it's actually Manabu Orido, and Orido is his second name, Max Orido, and Dimitri Engelbert. They'll be your podium for the pro racers And the podium for the amateur races will be Viberti, Zernadini and Dinora. And that's why we've got six cars down in the pit lane at the moment. There's the results on your screen, number 114. And look at that gap at the end of the day, 3.8 seconds when he crossed the line. Yatanaga wasn't out there. Manabu Orido, they've still got the name the wrong way around on your screen at the moment. And then Dimitri Angelbert in third place. Tanaga didn't go out there. If he'd gone out there, the times would have been a lot slower. So that was Rido for the whole race long there. And Andrew Palmer, the time will go so quickly. They've got a big sign up down by the cart. Number one, 1-4. And they've blanked out, almost blanked out the 1-4 with the sign that goes over the pit lane window. So taking the pit lane door, not window, but the pit lane door, there's the big signs for the drivers and names and the number of the car. And all the numbers are sort of grayed out from the first one down. And it worked out so well for Andrew Palmer because it just says number one. And you can just see the Dusky 1-4 next to it. And one of his team holding it up there. And that's gone on the front of the car now. You're seeing Andrew Palmer and the windscreen wipers going in slow motion as he comes around the infield section of here. And to be honest, and I will say this honestly, from the beginning of the race, I thought that with Angelbert behind him and the 28-year-old Frenchman, he's got a lot of experience behind him. And I was thinking, well, Andrew, you've had a good run here at a track that you don't know in conditions which are very, very iffy. And Angelbert, well, we've seen what he could do in the past. And this time, Angelbert, number 77, the runner-up last year from Aviatrix Racing. He's 28 years old from Luxembourg. From France. You said Luxembourg, that's the team entry from Luxembourg. And we know what he can do. But Andrew Palmer was a little bit of an unknown here. And just a shock to the system when he appeared in his first race at Virginia. And it's been a little bit of a shock to the system here as well. And it's a perfect car to have standing at the head of everybody else in pit lane. That chrome and red colour scheme, easy to pick out. And that's what we're looking at. Well, that's what I'm looking at now. You're looking at the screen and seeing him coming around the track again. Sorry about the squawking sound here. I've got the zip undone from the jacket. That's what you get, the squawking sound of the cord rubbing up and down the jacket because it is so cold here. We've got so many jackets on. And around about 5 or 6 degrees here at Vallelunga. An excellent pair of races for a world final. And there's going to be a lot of interest in this. And a lot of people are going to be looking at this and saying the Blancpain, the Lamborghini Blancpain Super Trofeo series now on three different series all coming together for the world final. And those that didn't manage to get here, Max Wieser, the champion from Asia, probably be kicking himself and saying, I should have, you know, should have just gone over there. And that's the one champion that we didn't have here. We had the North American champion, the European champion, but Max Wieser, the one of the two pro and amateur champions from the Asian series, we didn't get over here, which is a real shame. But Andrew Palmer, well, all credit to him. There's not much more I can say about him. He's been absolutely brilliant, been driving the wheels off that Lamborghini this time around. 19-year-old from Chicago. He won the national karting title in 2010 and followed that up with quite a few domestic and international podiums, but he hadn't experienced racing at all in a real car, in a fully fledged car. And thanks to test and development program running concert with the Thermal Club private racing circuit, that's near Palm Springs in California. He got a little bit of really crucial seat time and experience before arriving at VIR, but Virginia International Raceway was, in truth, his very, very first race in a car. He'd been in a kart before. Number 14, Gallardo LP570s, because that's what everybody drives here. He started fourth as a result of the previous day's race because he was fourth in the first race. And he had pole for the first race, but still came fourth. So Dimitri Angelbert leaps up to third place on the podium. as drivers come out. Hopefully, I was told that you didn't get the national anthem on the fold back from the first time. You just got silence when I was remaining silent for, as you do, obligatory, for the national anthem. Hopefully we'll hear it this time. And Manubu Arido, 45-year-old, on the podium in second place. Great for him. And here's your overall victor, the young 19-year-old, first year at uni. Hey, Dad, I got a car. Definitely do. That Lamborghini, four-wheel drive Lamborghini, has suited you down to the ground. And the American National Anthem, especially for Andrew out there. Andrew Palmer on the top step of the podium. And hopefully you heard the national anthem on the fold back down. I could tell that people were trying to bring it to you. And you'd enjoy it. What this man's enjoying, just think back to the time when you started university, your first year at university, you were a sophomore, and just feel what this guy is feeling at the moment. The world final. This is not just a big deal of winning a race at home in Virginia, or it's not actually from Virginia, it's from Chicago, but a race at home, on home soil, as you would imagine, then coming over here all the way to Italy with your father in tow as well. And then getting up there, not only on the podium in race one, but also race two as well, and a race two victory at that. And being able to go home and your friends say, hey, what did you do this weekend? Oh, I won the world final at Vallelunga in Rome. As they spray the champagne around. Max Arido has a quick guzzle of his as well. Dimitri trying to hand a bottle to somebody. I think he's taking that with him. And Andrew Palmer has another go at the top and hands up his trophy for all the photographers down there to take pictures of it. I'll take that one at home. That will go on Facebook, I can tell you. That will go on the website. Just having a look at how his race went, race two of Virginia International Raceway, and a great start. He went into the lead just minutes into the event and just took everything away from everybody else, and he's done it again. That is it from Vallelunga for the Lamborghini Blancpain Super Trofeo World Final Race 2, an American victory, and he will go home as overall champion from the World Final here. The Super Trofeo will again start again next year. I've got my fingers crossed for that, and we'll see as good racing as we've had at all three series, the North American, the Asian, and the European season series. But Andrew Palmer walks away with the biggest trophy of all. We'll see you with the Lamborghini Blancpain Super Trofeo races next year. Until then, it's Clive James McNeil saying bye-bye for now.